Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to discuss about opium, which is a somniferous drug. So opium refers to the dried extract of poppy plant. There's a plant commonly called poppy plant whose scientific name is Papaver somniferum. So opium is derived from the dried extract of this plant. And this plant belongs to the family Papaveraceae. Here you can see in the picture 13.1, it is poppy plant, and 13.2, you can see the capsule of the poppy plant. This is the portion from where opium is extracted whenever there's an incision made. Here you can see there's a cut made and a milky fluid substance is coming out from it. So that is the drug that is extracted from the plant. It is a herb that grows up to 1 meter in height. Then the unripe fruit capsule gives a milky fluid, as you can see in the picture, that on drying yields opium. Now the crude opium is dark brown in color or grayish in color. It is irregular mass and it has a characteristic odor and bitter taste. So if you talk about the toxic part, then the fruit capsule that we are seeing, that is the toxic part. Now the toxic principles. Opium obtained from the unripe fruit capsule has 25 alkaloids in total. So these 25 alkaloids, they mainly fall into two categories, which is phenanthrene group and benzyl isoquinolone group. So let's discuss what all comes under these groups. In phenanthrene groups, there are three further divisions, that is natural, semi-synthetic and synthetic. In natural comes morphine, codeine and thibane. In semi-synthetic comes oxycodone, oxymorphone, hydromorphone, diacetylmorphine, which is also known as heroin or brown sugar. Then for synthetic ones come fentanyl, methadone, pentazocine, tramadol and meperidine, which is also called pethidine. Fentanyl is 100 times more potent than morphine and it is about 50 times more potent than heroin. Then the next category, benzyl isoquinoline group, includes papaverine and scapine, also known as narcotine. If you talk about the mode of action, then they work by binding to the opioid receptors that are present on the neurons that are distributed throughout the nervous system and the immune system. Now there are four main receptors onto which the opioids attaches themselves. It includes mu, kappa, delta and a newly recognized one, OFQ/N receptor. So the first one is mu receptor. It is also known as OP3 receptor and consists of two subtypes, M1 and M2, also called OP3A and OP3B. Then the kappa receptor is also known as OP2 and it consists of three types, K1, K2 and K3, also known as OP2A, OP2B and OP2C. Then delta receptor is also known as OP1 and it is said to be important in the spinal and supraspinal analgesics. And there's a newly recognized receptor called OFQ/N. So these are the receptors onto which the opioids, they bind. So this binding results in the inhibition of synaptic neurotransmission in CNS, central nervous system, and PNS, peripheral nervous system. If we talk about the route of administration, then that can be snorting, that is taking in with the help of nose. Then it can be smoking. Then it can be intravenous, also called mainlining, when the drug is directly injected inside the veins, that's called intravenous. Then there's subcutaneous, that is inside the skin, also known as skin popping. Then chasing the dragon. Chasing the dragon means taking the drug onto a thin aluminium plate and then a flame is applied onto the lower surface of the aluminium. So due to which what happens is that the aluminium metal gets heated and the drug kept on it also heated and gets converted into smoke form, and then that smoke is taken by the person. That is called chasing the dragon. Then opioids can also be mixed with cocaine. This is known as speedballing. If you talk about the clinical features, then there's a triad which includes coma, pinpoint pupils and respiratory depression. These are the most common feature of opioid poisoning. Then bradypnea is a common feature. Morphine induced seizures are also seen, and cramping, constipation as well as sphincter of Oddi spasm may also be seen. Then there are three stages of signs and symptoms, which includes first stage of excitement, stage of second stage of stupor, and third stage of narcosis. In stage of excitement, it is a short duration stage and it consists of euphoria. There's increased sense of well-being, freedom from anxiety. The person is going to feel very good. Then comes stage of stupor, which includes headache, nausea, vomiting, weakness, heaviness and all. Then comes last stage of narcosis or coma, stage of coma. Then if you talk about treatment, then first of all, we need to support the vital organs through respirator, because this opium is going to lead to respiratory depression, as I have told. So we need to support the vitals through respirator. Then decontamination should be done, in which stomach wash is done frequently with KMnO4 solution, 1:5000 KMnO4 solution, leaving some solution in the stomach itself in order to oxidize the alkaloid that is present in the stomach after absorption. Then, and there's an antidote for this, the narcotic antagonist called naloxone is the antidote for opium poisoning. It is given initially in the dose of 0.4 to 2 mg IV intravenously or IM intramuscular way, and then it is repeated every 2 to 3 minutes up to 10 gram. If no response occurs, then this repetition is made. Then if we talk about detection, then there's a test called Marquis test. Marquis test is used as a simple spot test to presumptively identify the alkaloids. So opium is a form of alkaloid. So this Marquis test can help us identify opium. This Marquis reagent is consist of malin and concentrated sulfuric acid. There is 3 ml of H2SO4 or sulfuric acid taken, to which 3 drops of formalin is taken or is added, and this whole mixture is added to the substance that is to be tested. Now if we see a purple red color that gradually changes to violet, then that means opium is present. Post-mortem findings include smell of opium, froth at nostrils. There can be a pink colors froth coming out from the mouth of the person. Then face or body is bluish sinused or blackish. Pupils are constricted. They also might be dilated. Then the needle tracks may be found if the opium mode of the route of administration of opium is intravenous. Then needle tracks may be found in the body of the person. So this was all about the opium or the somniferous poison. I hope you understood everything, and if you have any problem or you think I've missed out anything, then please do let me know in the comment section. And please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Share it with your friends as much as you can. Thank you.